Hello everyone, my name is Alec Gall, and I'm the product manager for Active Reports at Grape City. Today I'll be running you through a quick 10-minute demo to show you the basics of creating a report with the Active Reports Blazor Web Designer. I'll barely be scratching the surface of what you can do with Active Reports here, but hopefully this will give you a good idea of the power you can give your end users with Active Reports and how easy it is to use. What I have here in Visual Studio is our pre-built Blazor sample with the web designer set up and ready to go. If you want to test it out for yourself, you can find it on our GitHub page, and it also gets installed straight onto your machine with the install of Active Reports. So I'll go ahead and start this up. And there we have the web designer. First thing we'll want to do is add a data source, of course. So just go over here to the data tab. As you can see, there's a handful of providers here for some of the most popular options. I'm just going to do some embedded JSON here for the sake of making this extra simple for the demo. Then I'm going to go ahead and add a data set from that data source. So I'm going to grab my products table. Okay, and that's all we have to do to add the data. So from here, we're obviously going to want to put the data somewhere. So I'm going to grab a table control and just drag that straight on here. Okay, make that a little bigger. Okay, now that we have a table created, we can easily drag and drop fields straight from our data set over here and just drop them straight into our table. So I'm going to take product name, and I'm going to take units in stock. If we just click preview, we can see it's just listing all of our product names and how many units are in stock for each one of those products. And the report will expand until it runs out of items. Not terribly useful on its own, but we're going to keep expanding this and turn this into a usable report. Okay, so now what we're going to do is just sort the table by the number of units in stock. So all I have to do for that is to select the table here, look for sort expressions. I'm going to go ahead and add one here, and then I'm going to use this button to expand the expression editor. And this will just be very simple, just curly bracket to start an expression, then units in stock, and in the brackets. And just like that, it should be sorted by the number of units in stock. I'm going to change that to be descending instead. So let's go ahead and start adding a bit more data. So let's grab the unit price. And then let's change the format of that to currency so it has the proper symbols and decimal places. Okay. As you can see there, it's currently formatted to the US dollar. Okay, and then let's create another field here. We will add another column. And then we can make a calculated field by just adding an expression straight into this text box here. So I'm going to do units in stock times unit price. And that will give us our stock value. Let's just preview that, make sure everything's good to go. Yep, I will add the currency format though. Okay, now on a quick glance, we can see how many units in stock we have for each of our products, what each product is worth individually, and the total value of our stock for that product. Okay, so let's go ahead and try to make this a little bit more useful by setting up a group to group this data by the category. So I'll just click in here again, go to group, and insert group. Now that we've got our group created here, let's go ahead and set the group expression. So I'm going to select our group. I'm going to go over here and add a group expression, which is going to set what we're grouping by. So I'll set this to category name. That's all we have to do. But I'm also going to go ahead and add category name here so that it displays it in our group header as well. And then I'm also going to just go ahead and get rid of the group footer and the normal footer because I don't intend to use it here. So let's go ahead and preview this, make sure everything's working. Okay, so now we've got our table nicely grouped in different product categories, beverages, condiments, produce, etc. Okay, before we move on to something else, let's go ahead and just add a couple more things to the group header here. So first, I'll go ahead and just get the sum of the units in stock. So this will take the sum of all of the fields that are in that particular category. So I'm just gonna go ahead and add an expression here. Then I'll do sum, parentheses, units in stock. Then I'll go ahead and do the same thing for our stock value column. And basically, I'm just going to be putting that same expression from before that we used to calculate the field in this expression. Okay, let's go ahead and preview this then. Okay, so now we've got a sum of each of those columns in each of these categories. I'm going to go ahead and add the currency format to those as well though. Oops, just the stock value. Okay. Let's just preview that again really quick to make sure everything is good. All right, looks good. Okay, now I think one of the most useful things we could do with a table like this for our hypothetical store manager is to add some conditional formatting to let them know when the units in stock are getting close to the reorder level. So first off, let's go ahead and add another column here. And then let's drag our reorder level field over. And now we'll select units in stock again. And we will set our background color to an expression. So this expression that's currently in here is set by the default theme. It's what's determining which row will be blue or white, depending on whether it's odd or even. So I'm just going to get rid of that for this particular column. Okay, I'm going to set our new expression here. That's going to be if units in stock is greater than reorder level, set it to pale green. If else, set it to light coral. So basically what that should do is check if units in stock is greater than reorder level, Then if it is, it's going to set it to green. If it's not, it's going to set it to red. And let's give that a try. Okay, boom, there we go. So now it's nice and clear for our store manager here that the highlighted columns in red are ready to be reordered, and the ones in green are currently good on stock so far. Okay, so now our simple report is fairly useful for a store manager to get a quick idea of their stock levels. So let's go ahead and make it a little more presentable and organized, though, by adding some page breaks and a table of contents. Okay, so I'm going to select our group again. Then I'm going to set the page break to start. So that's going to add a page break right before the category for every category in our table. So if we go ahead and preview that now, we'll find that the first page is going to be blank, but that's fine because we're going to add the table of contents there in a second. But then on each page, it'll start with the very beginning of each category. I'm just going to move our table over a little bit here. And then move it down a bit, make some room for our table of contents. Actually, I'm going to move it all the way to the bottom. Since the page break is making a new page right at the beginning of each category, it doesn't actually matter where we put the table because it'll always appear at the very top of the next page. So let's go ahead and grab our table of contents, and I'll just put that up at the top for now. And you'll see there's just a level one here so far, and that's really all we need. We're not going to add any more of these levels here because we're just sorting by this one category. So now we need to hop into our table here and link something to level one. So I'm going to select our category name here. And then I'm going to scroll down all the way to the very bottom to heading level. And then I'm just going to set that to one. And just like that, it should be this category name field here at the, in the header of our group should be linked to level one of our table of contents. So I'll go ahead and preview that now. Okay, and there's our table of contents. It's got the page number for each of our categories here. And then if you click on any one of these, it'll actually act as a bookmark and take you straight to that category. All right, so now our report's fairly useful. I don't think a chart is terribly necessary for a report like this, but for the sake of the demo, I'm just gonna add one anyway. So let's go ahead and just grab a chart here. I'll put it just under our table of contents. I'm just gonna do a standard column chart. Then for our data values, I'm going to link that to units in stock here. And then for data categories, that will of course be category name. And just like that, we have our chart. I'm going to expand it just to make it a little bigger here. Okay, give it a preview. And there we have it. We've got our table of contents, we've got our charts. Get a quick glimpse of what's in stock for each category. And then you can go to each page and check what needs stocked per product. All right, so that's about all we have time for today. Again, my name is Alec Gull, and I'm the product manager for Active Reports over at Grape City. I hope this quick demo gave you a good idea of what you could do with Active Reports in our Blazor Web Designer, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.